Welcome back to my channel, and for those of you who haven't been here before, welcome. So I'm gonna go straight in on the face, and I'm starting with this Borjouis healthy mix serum, and I'm just speeding up the process here because it's not any different from previous videos, from my most recent video, that is. And I'm just blending it out, of course, dabbing that into the skin with a beauty blender, which is my favorite way of applying foundation. I feel that's the most natural thing. And that's the thing with this look today. I want to concentrate on the skin, that it's dewy. So that is why it is very important to make it look as natural as possible. And I'm just speeding through here. Going in with my concealer from Mememe Flawless Concealer. I feel like this is the concealer that gives the most natural look. As I said, I wanted to keep it very natural, and this concealer does the trick. So again, sped it up, and I was happy about it. And here I'm just pressing it into the skin, and as you can see, I'm going over the lid, which I rarely do, but today I am because I'm not applying any eyeshadow. Well, I'm applying some shadow, but not that much. Going in with the NYX HD Finishing Powder in Banana, I'm just gonna set my under eye and everywhere that I have put on concealer and foundation, basically. And as you can see, I'm dabbing with my beauty blender first, just to get those creases out, and then I'm keeping my face very still and going in with the powder all over, both under and over my eye. And of course, I'm doing the same thing in my forehead, and here I'm just dusting off any excess powder. And then I'm trying to carve out my cheekbones before I go in with bronzer, and just sort of baking a little here. Well, my attempt to bake. And then I'm just dusting that off as well. Little out of focus. Going in with my Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit, I'm taking the color Sand, which I've been obsessed with for the past few months, which I told you in my previous tutorial, and I'm basically dusting that everywhere on my face and of course over my lid, since I'm not going in with any shadow. And yeah, you know, dusting it everywhere. And then dipping in to the middle contour shade right here. Can't remember the name right now. I will link that in the description box. I'm just running through that through my crease just to carve out my crease area a bit, because I just wanted to have some extra, what's it called? Shadow? Extra dimension to the eyes, even though I'm leaving them basically blank. I'm just blending it upwards so it becomes natural. And then going in with the Maybeline Master Ink in Matte. And this is it, guys. Say a little prayer from me. And that's why I'm doing this right now, because I've never done this on camera before. Now, my YouTube channel is very new, but I've been dreading this moment to apply my eyeliner on camera. It's hard enough to apply it off camera, so I always, you know, say a little prayer before I do my eyeliner. But right now, well, today, it was sort of smooth sailing, luckily. I know it looks like I'm in pain when I apply my eyeliner, but that's just, you know, my facial expressions. Can't do anything about it. Just making sure that the lines are somewhat alike, and well, they look alike, I'm happy. Then I'm gonna go in with my favorite lashes, which are the Haute Cotour lashes by Kiss. And this is in the style Jazzy, since I wanted to keep it, well, natural today. And I have, again, sped up the process because, again, this is something I've shown before. Then I'm going in to do my brows, and I'm keeping it, again, very simple today. So I'm going in with my Maybeline Brow Drama, which is the sculpting mascara, brow mascara, and I use this every day. And like I said in my previous tutorial, if it's not broken, why fix it? I think I said that. I meant to say it. If I didn't say it, I did say it. At least say it now. Then going on to the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette, I'm taking that middle shade again and just dusting it on to my cheekbones. I'm bronzing. That's what I'm doing. I'm not contouring that much. I'm contouring a little bit, but not that much. And Mama likes her bronzed forehead, so I'm creating what someone would call a bronzed helmet, a bronzer helmet. And here I'm just baking, just, you know, to clean up that under contour, if you will, and dusting it off, of course. Then here I'm almost disappearing out of frame, just to clean up that liner, just fill it in. And I feel like it's much more easier to see if they're even or not when I have applied my lashes, so that's what I'm doing. And since I'm leaving my lower lash line blank, well, from mascara that is, I'm going in with some brown shade. And here I'm just curling my lashes, yes, with my false lashes on. I do that from time to time, don't judge. And going in with the Colossal Go Extreme Volume Mascara and just dabbing that on my lashes. And as you can see, I'm barely touching, and that's just to get those inner lashes coated. Then I need that glow, you know, so I'm going in with Hot Mama Blush by TheBalm. Because it has a beautiful highlight into it, I felt like I needed to wear that one today, so that's what I'm doing right here. And then dipping into some Shimmer Shimmer by Makeup Geek, I'm just gonna highlight my brow bone and my inner corner, you know, just to give some extra highlight. Then moving on to Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in Opal. Again, I want to glow today, so I'm putting that, again, basically everywhere. Down my nose, cheekbones, forehead, you name it, you got it. Then for lips, I'm going in with this Yves Saint Laurent shade in 2, I believe. I don't remember the name, but finishing it off with Chill Makeup Setting Spray. And that is the complete look.